What is it like working with Mr. Johnson, and what does he bring to this work?
He's very enthusiastic. He has a lot of energy, and he does an amazing job of establishing rapport with the students that he comes in contact with. I love how he, you know, he, when they come in the room, he fist bumps with them to just like make that connection as they're coming in the room to try and encourage the positivity and keep the flow going.
Yeah, and in the classroom, he makes the students feel as if, you know, it's their classroom. It's more student-led than him, you know, just standing up there giving a lecture. You know, he lets them give their own opinions or their different scenarios when we're in the classroom. So he does a great job with it.
Also, he does a great job at being humorous, to make the class more interesting, make the time go by quicker, and I think laughter does it for good. So the children have an opportunity to learn as well as have fun. Mm-hmm.
Now, I would say that he promotes leadership within the students and within the staff. He's consistently seeking leadership opportunities for the students and leadership opportunities for the staff anywhere that he can help. He's always doing that.
How has Mr. Johnson's work had an impact on the students' families and community in the Westwood area?
I think in regard to Mr. Johnson and all he does with student council and with the outside partners, he always wants to make sure that we're getting someone from this area that can actually come back and talk to the kids. He's not just going out and getting people that he knows, he's actually getting people that have come from the same school, the same background, to make sure that the kids understand that there is something outside of just the Westwood area. And you can, you know, overcome whatever obstacle because I was there. So
when we do the honors programs, he's always quick to have someone that he's willing to ask to come and talk to the kids and be an inspiration to them. And then he asks so many to help with the talent shows and the pageants.
Yeah.
And even with the student council and just having people come in and just talk and interact with the kids and try and show them, I was here, but now I'm here. Mm-hmm. It doesn't have to stop here. You can have better.
Right. I think he does a lot of parental involvement, especially when it comes to the pageant.
Yeah.
We have a hard time getting parents to come out and do things, but he gets the parents actively involved in the pageant, and we get more parent support that way.
And not just even the parents, he gets the businesses involved.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the whole community is literally involved. Parents, students, businesses that are surrounding the area.
The ads,
everybody is getting involved with,
donations,
you know, the programs that he does or brings to the school.
And even with the students, you know, with him bringing the outside resources as far as the people to come and do their hair and makeup, he actually, you know, builds the young lady's self-esteem up. So they know that, you know, wow, I can look beautiful, you know.
Mm-hmm. For the pageant last year, he would use my room because he had the boys do, he had men come and work with the boys and ladies come and work with the ladies. And I got to see some of the different lectures that they did with them, or not lectures, but interactions that they did with them, and just about what it means to be a lady, what it means to protect yourself and your body. And then with the gentlemen, when the gentlemen were in my room, they were teaching the boys how to tie a tie,
right?
Mm-hmm.
How to present yourself, you know. And it doesn't mean just always wearing a suit and tie, but it just means how you carry yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember sitting there, I was supposed to be working, and all I could do was just pay attention to what was going on. You know, trying to be productive, but I was just so impressed with what was happening from these people who have nothing to do with our kids and are willing to give their time to come and teach our kids how to be ladies and gentlemen. So.
How has Mr. Johnson been a part of the community, and what partnerships or relationships has he formed outside of the school?
I think we just kind of touched on a lot of that. Just the choreographers, the volunteers that come and present, that interact, the parents that come. come and work, or even if they don't come and help with the pageant, they support their children and the children that are a part of it by
donating dresses, or doing
whatever, you know. So I think that's pretty phenomenal.
And even the Young Democrats, when they came in for the Young Democrats and teaching them about, you know, law and policies and all of those things, so that they can get involved and know what it means to vote and what, you know, that your opinion matters.
Right, your opinion does matter. And going to see the mayor and going to be the congressman, taking them on those opportunities. The picture that he has somewhere, I know he's got it up somewhere, but, you know, where they're all with the congressman, I think that's pretty amazing.
Yeah.
I think it's probably like behind a desk.
How is Mr. Johnson leading students that prepares them and gets them ready to be a part of the global community?
Once again,
just by being a positive role model.
His drive with the student council. I mean, he goes out of his way to make sure that those that have decided to be a part of the council here at school, that they are given multiple opportunities to interact with what it means to be a citizen in the United States and how to go about making positive changes within whatever communities you're a part of. Just having the kids voice what they like or dislike about Chickasaw, taking that to the admin, encouraging the president and the vice president to present at Motivation, the morning motivations, you know, just making them be a part of this community so that hopefully when they become adults, they will continue to be a part of their community.
And I think taking those field trips outside of the school, like to the mayor's office and other things like that, that helps the children to understand, oh, I am capable of doing this. Oh, I am capable, you know, becoming a better citizen by doing this, that, and the other. Because when they go out, they're seeing, okay, what we're learning in school is outside as well.
Yeah.
So they're able to make the connection.
And he goes and seeks kids. So not just the kids who, you know, are, oh, I want to do it. He seeks those kids who he sees leadership within them, and he's like just bringing it up out of them. So
trying to build that confidence. And then what personal values does he display that allows him to overcome obstacles or challenges? And I think the thing that jumps in my mind is that he's willing to admit when he's made a mistake, and he does that in front of the kids. That's a very humble thing to be able to do that and to say, oh, I was wrong, whether it's to a child or to another adult, and let that be seen, you know, because we all do make mistakes. So I think the fact that he's willing to put himself out there and acknowledge that mistakes can be made is a personal value that allows him to overcome personal challenges or obstacles, especially in today's society and in this profession.
And I think by him being one of those kids that always got in trouble when he was in school, he's able to relate more to the kids here and able to, you know, give back and show them this is what you can do, this is what you can become. You know, you don't always have to be labeled as this bad kid or this behavior issue. And he changes their mindset with that. If they, you know, I'm bad, I used to be this, but when they come in here, it's like, oh, this child has really changed, you know. And I guess being a product of that, you can have that relationship.
And I think it's important that he will go to bat for the kids. Like, he doesn't care who it is. If he thinks that it's right and it's going to benefit the kids, he's going to make sure his voice is heard, the kids' voice is heard. So I think that's very important.
So his involvement with making sure that, you know, if it's not right, then I'm going to let you know that it's not right. And like Ms. Sanders said, just making sure that the kids feel that safe space with him. And he just builds that rapport with them, because he wants them to know that, I mean, you know, like,
I got your back.
I've been there. You can make it.
Right. So him just being himself is one of the things that helps him overcome mm-hmm. most of those obstacles, because I had that instilled in me, and I'm going to instill those same values in you that I have, because I know the purpose. It's not because I'm fussing. It's not because I don't think it'll help you, or because I'm trying to make you into something that you don't want to be. But I know your potential.
Right. Right. Because I've been there. And look at me.
Right.
You can do it.